We're at Glendalough State Park right now. This is one of the two usable lakes, but there's three lakes. There's one more on the other side of these woods, but the border of the park touches the bottom of that lake. This one here, you can do all kinds of things. You can rent canoes and paddle boards and all that. And they have a little information center, and you got picnics here. It's obviously some kind of event center, auditorium or whatever. Okay, let's go in. We just gotta get out of the woods. Alright, in out of the wind. In the woods, out of the wind, how's that? Whoop. I'm supposed to be on my way to town getting groceries, but I took the long way around. Kind of surprised it's Monday today, you know, and being 3:30 in the afternoon, I'm surprised there's anyone here for that matter, but there's a half a dozen cars here. Oh, geez, there's a hole there. Huh, Annie Battle Lake. That's what this one's called. I can never remember the name. There's Molly Stark and Annie Battle Lake. But you can see how nice the woods are here. So I'm thinking if we just take our time, kind of poke along. Sorry, my water bottle sloshes when I walk. I have it in my hoodie pocket. And my chest mount's right there. And it's too cold to put in my hand. I'm full of excuses. Just deal with it. I'm not going to be here long. Just breaking up my day. I was in the area, like I said, I took the long way around to go to the grocery store. This is another one of those parks that's really nice to come in the fall. A lot of fall foliage in here. You know, being all mostly oaks. Yeah, we may not see many animals. I can still hear people and kids screaming. this trail connects to the bike trail that goes around the whole park. And the majority of the people walk that. There they are, right there. It's paved all the way around. Keep catching my feet on the roots. I feel like a rookie. I don't know if you can see it, but there's part of the paved bike trail right there between these trees. This eventually bumps into it. There, now maybe you can see it. Almost forgot the wind's blowing. These trees really block a lot of it. Can't help but stop and want to look around. Down just a tad more here. Not seeing so much skyline. Yeah, keep that up. Definitely see some animals. All this is wide open because of the deer. They just browse this all down. Too bad you can't ride a mountain bike on this trail. That'd be a lot of fun. I'm sure you probably could. Nobody would really say anything. This park isn't really monitored hard like that. It's a lot quieter in here now. I don't think I hear anybody. Right here is the bike trail. We're going to go this way a little bit. It's a pretty nice bike trail. very little of it is beat up in any way. There might be a handful of, you know, patches and stuff like that, but there's no holes or missing pavement or tar. It's pretty smooth all the way around. I heard a squirrel off in the distance. We're due for a good week of weather in the 40s. Hopefully it won't be really windy. It'd be nice to have 40 degree days that feel 40. Show you this. Remember when I was saying this is all opened up like it is because of deer browsing? They put these fences up to stop the deer. This is what it looks like when the deer don't browse it, because they can't get in there, so they're not going to bother to jump in there. Put it that way. You'd really notice it in the fall. Because all that would be one big patch of leafy trees and then everything else around it. This one's not a really good example because there's so much falling around it. See if I can find another one. There used to be a bunch of them in here. They fenced off areas for to monitor the browse, and if it gets too bad, then they'd open up a hunting season. But that would probably never happen here. That explains it right there, the deer exclosure. But that sign says exactly the same thing I just told you. There's a corner coming up down here. That's the best part of it. Well, I don't want to say the best part, but that's kind of a fun part here on the bike trail. and it happens to be right where a hiking trail joins it. I hear voices over here. Yeah, in this corner. Whipping around this corner on a bike, but we're not gonna go that way. Well, I can't really see it because I got it all beat up. But yeah, we're gonna go down and walk the ridge line, the Ice Ridge Trail. It's kind of cool. This used to go all the way for quite a while, and you still can do it. It's not like you can't walk around this bench, but now they just make it go that way. But I've come up that way before plenty of times, so it's not like you can't. This might be a little weird with the sun in our eyes. This is one of my favorite trails. This is the one I've seen the most wildlife on. That's, yeah, right. Wish I could remember the name of the lake. But this is the border right here, that line where the lake is. That's the border of the park. through all these trees, or trying to get through all these trees or something. That low roar you hear is the wind coming across the lake. You probably can't see it, but tops of these trees are just a swaying. So the reason this trail is called Ice Ridge Trail is because over years and years and years, the wind whipping across that lake, I can see there's another ridge starting right there. The wind coming across the lake will push the ice, and it just keeps pushing the earth until it finally melts in the spring. But layer by layer, it'll push the ice until it finally cracks and gets up on top of itself. And then it really gets momentum and pushes. And then the next piece of breaking it up on top of that. And it'll stage, keep staging up and keep pushing and pushing. And it pushes all the topsoil up just like this. All the dirt. This is one big ridge that we're walking across, all formed by ice. But you can kind of see, I can see it, but like especially over this one, that dark line is another ridge forming from exactly the same thing happening. Down here a ways, not long ways, but down here at the end of the trail, there's signs that actually explain it. And there's a really big ice ridge. I still hear people. It gets dark about 6 o'clock now. So pretty soon people will start to head out. But then again, we'll be gone too. thinking I'm probably going to wait and get groceries tomorrow. Not that I want to. I'm halfway to the grocery store or halfway home. So, and I have plenty of food. Can't tell if they're coming at us or not because of the sunshine in my eyes. Yep, seems so. Mom was looking for something. Wanted to show the kids, but couldn't find one. Might have actually been looking for a deer shed. All along in there is, and here is a good location. They know the deer bed in here. Both sides, actually. But yeah. I've been coming to this park for over 20 years. And way back in the day, when I first started coming here, people really didn't come here much. It was a lot different. I used to come in here with my old Pantax K1000 with a 205 zoom, and I would just come out here and find places and sit like most of the day in full camo and see very few people and see a lot of deer. That was way different back then. You still see deer now and then, but I mean, they're in here. Don't get me wrong, there's a lot of deer in here. But they know where to go and hide during the day when it picks up, gets busy, more people around. Well, I hope you're getting a decent view with the sun in your eyes. Yeah, we just walked from here to there, from here to there. Lake Blanche, that's the big lake out there. I wonder why I can never remember the name. We can walk a little like this. What do we got here? This place used to be so different back in its heyday before it was a state park. This was not always a state park. This used to be a game farm for the well-to-do, the health, the wealthy, well, the healthy. People used to pay good money to come here to hunt wildlife. It also had a golf course, which is where we're going to come out here pretty quick. This opens up to the big ice ridge attraction that I was talking about earlier, and where the little golf course was. Well, yeah, it would have been fun to be a part of this back in its heyday. See, it starts to thin out here a little bit. This is still Ice Ridge Trail. Actually, down here is the reason why this is called Ice Ridge Trail. They just decided to put the trail all along that one ice ridge that we just walked on. Could see how big the lake is. I can feel more of the wind coming at us now too. It's a pretty big lake, and it's not even a big one. There's another bigger lake on the other side of that. You'll see more of it in a minute here. We'll get up here in the open. That right there, that ridge, that's why this trail is called Ice Ridge. That ridge was formed by ice being pushed off that lake. There's more right here being formed to this day. We'll walk over there in a minute and I'll show you. But yeah, all that was pushed up by ice. The water used to be way up in here, So it used to be, it used to look way different. I'd be walking in water right now, in other words. That's why that ridge is so far in. This out here, part of it used to be where the golf course was, back over there. That used to be way different. Of course, like I said, the water used to be way up in here. So, I'm not even sure how that worked, but there's a sign over there, a storyboard sign, tells about it. But let's go up here. I'll show you how the new ridges are starting to form. And you'll get a perfect example because there's a big one going on right now. See all this dirt, how it's pushed up here. Hold on. I'm not sure which way is a better view. But all this dirt right here. All this was pushed up by ice. All this all the way down. You can see this whole ridge down through here, all the way around the corner. All this was pushed up from the ice and the wind. Wind come whipping across the ice, the lake. All this right here, pushed up by ice. And over the years, this will just keep moving in and in, further and further. Especially right here off this flat, because there's a big flat right here. You can see the grass coming up through the ice. So it's probably only, you know, 8 inches to 2 foot deep for a long ways out. So it pushes all the dirt from the bottom up into here. You can see all the grass is piled up right here. It'll just keep pushing it and pushing it over the years. It's crazy how that works. This is a duck blind box. That's what that is. You sit in that with your shotgun. It's looking out there. And just put a blind over it. Cover, some kind of cover over it. And you shoot ducks that land right here. Because it's such a flat and it's got all this grass. And throw some decoys out there. They'll land right in front of you. Oh. But yeah, all this was pushed up by ice, wind, and ice. Pretty crazy. Okay, let's go walk the river back. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. I can hear the geese over there floating around in the river. Maybe we'll get lucky. I might even see an otter. Still not a bad day though, with the wind making it cool. Aww. Why would you do that? Somebody took the sign down. That's the sign that actually talked about the golf course. I purposely walked over here to show you that. Well, you can really see there how the ice pushed up that. Oh, those, that was so jagged. Pretty neat. Oh, well, you're not going to learn about the golf course. I might be getting overly excited. Maybe they took all the signs and gotta get them remade or something. Because it is winter time. Sun feels good. I'm really being blocked by the wind now with this ridge in my way. I really wish you could see that. How big that is being pushed by ice. I feel a weird and out of balance without my trekking poles. The trails here in the summer are always mowed. I mean, they're mowed as low as it is right now, pretty much. They have on-ground staff here all the time. Oh, come around the corner and a big gush of wind. This is one of the little hideaways, off-trail spots. In summertime, you can barely see all these cattails are way taller. There's fish in this though. One of the biggest bass I ever caught in my life, I caught up around this corner. Up there near the bridge. There's fish in here. Well, why wouldn't there be? This river ties two lakes together. It's connected to two lakes. Goes out of the north end of one and into the south end of the other. This is a pretty good view. Oh, we got people coming there. We'll stand here long enough to let them go by. Won't be on camera. Hello. If I remember right, yep, here it is. Wow, that tree almost fell right on it. This is a dog cemetery. Looks like they're trying to clean it up, though. Oh, it did fall on it. A doggy cemetery. Pretty neat. Hunting dogs from back in the day. Not all of them, but like the sign said. Yeah. Gotta visit them every time I come here. I bet the waterfowl hunting here was insane, because there's just so much ducks and geese and snow geese, cranes, you name it. If it lives in the water or uses water, they're here. Little snipes that are along the edges, they're in here. Another cool little cutout. We're almost to the bridge now. You can see the new building over there that they're building. This is one of the better spots for catching fish, because you can stand here and cast up and pull them out of the grass. But this water moves pretty good. Yep, they took all the signs. I just noticed that one over there. The sign's missing too, so it must be maybe gonna make new ones. I don't know. I can't imagine somebody come in here and vandalize all the signs. They've been here for years. But some of them were really sun faded. Like you couldn't even read them anymore. It's smart. This will never rot away. Except for the beams that are underneath holding it up. But well, maybe if I do decide to go grocery shopping instead of back home, this hike justifies the fact that I could get a cheeseburger from Dairy Queen. Although that's talking me more into going right straight home. Pretty close to the end of the trail here. There we go. Into the trail in the woods. Yeah, they really did. They took all the signs. I mean, it's good if they're going to replace them with new ones. That's cool. But we're not going to go that way. The van's over there. Those are for parking your bike if you want to hike a trail, because you're not allowed to have bikes on the trails, hiking trails. Which is kind of odd, because I'm allowed to walk on this bike trail, but they're not allowed to ride on the hiking trails. These are twice as wide though. And I'm taking up, you know, 18 inches here. That was a good walk. Of course, I forgot to turn the tracker on to know how far it was. But that's typical me. I hardly ever remember put the tracker on. Well, if you're ever near Battle Lake, Minnesota, just go into any of the stores and say, hey, where's Glendalough State Park? And somebody will say, honey, you can walk there from here. No, they won't sound like that. This bike trail at the other end of it goes right into that town.